Hello? Hello? Can you let me in? I'm trying to get in.
Sorry, I'm sorry, what's going on?
I need to get in.
I'm sorry, the gate's locked. The gate's locked today. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, the gate is locked.
You know, I'm busy right now. Shabbat Shalom, friends. How are you? This week's Torah portion is all about Shoftim v'Shotrim, the importance of having police officers. And the Torah tells us that there's a commandment to place upon our gates Shoftim v'Shotrim titem lecha v'chol sha'arecha. We have to have police by every gate. What does that mean? What does that represent? So our sages teach us that in the truth, when we talk about gates, we are not just talking about something which exists in our homes. We're not just talking about something which exists in the walls of our cities. But in truth, every single human being has our own gates. What are the gates that we possess? That is our mouth, our eyes, our ears, the things we say, and the things we look at, and the things we listen to. We all have our gates. And just like the Torah tells us that there need to be police officers at the gates of the city, so too we need to ensure that we have our own inner security that ensures that our gates are also protected. We can't just say whatever we want. We can't just listen to whatever we want. We can't just look at whatever we want. We have to have a sense of control and inner security to ensure that we only allow goodness and positivity to enter our system, enter our mind, enter our hearts. You know, if you have a guest in your house who you really don't like, it's very hard to kick them out. But if you stop them from coming before they enter your zone, it's so much easier. This week's Torah portion reminds us the importance of controlling ourselves. Do you get the message?
I do.
All right, come on out.
Thank you so much, Rabbi. You know, this reminds me of a special story. A great disciple of a big rabbi came to me and asked him, "Rabbi, how can I stop my temptations? What should I do?" So he told him, "You know what? Go to a special friend of mine, a special student of mine, in the outskirts of the city." And he walks to him and he tells him, he stands at his door, and he bangs on the door and he waits for him to open, but he ignores him. And he sits there and he knocks and he knocks and he knocks and stands the whole night through the thunder and the lightning, through all the rain. He's sitting there in the snow. Morning comes. Finally, he opens the door. He says to him, "Why have you not let me in?" And says to him, "This is my home. And in my home, I choose who comes in." And he told him, he turns to him, he says, "I've come to ask you, what should I do about my temptations?" And he says, "This is what you do. When you decide who comes into your home, you don't let them come in. You choose who gets to come in to your own home."
But you know what? I actually saw an advertisement this morning for a new security system. If you sign up this month, it's $50 off every month. Let's invite our listeners to join us on the special security campaign. Everybody's watching this video free of charge. You can install an inner security system that allows you to control and guard what you see, what you hear, what you process, what you think about. And if you do that, you will have a much more peaceful and joyful week ahead. So together, let's wish you Shabbat Shalom.